Mr. Hichilema find himself on the board? Huh? How did his name appear? How much was he worth before the privatization process? Ms. Nawakwi was Minister of Finance under the MMD government. How did the government under the MMD regime allow for such a thing to happen? It's a simple issue. Why is this being brought up? We have heard Mr. Hichilema very loud calling the Patriotic Front ministers thieves. They're looting. They're thieving. We're going towards elections. People are looking at the political landscape. They either want to stay where they are or they want to shift. Should they decide to shift, where are they shifting to? Why should they shift to you? Are you any better? Are you corrupt yourself? Or are you as clean as a white sheet? Privatization has come up. You have constantly told the Zambian people how the PF are doing this and they're doing that and doing that. What makes you any better? Mm. What have you done for this country in the past? We are looking at a position of accountability and credibility of the candidates that are going to appear on the ballot paper next year. We are dealing with issues to do with 48 houses. Right now, we're still asking. We are still probing. We are still questioning, and we will continue to do that. We are still going to ask about fire tenders. We are still going to ask about anything else that doesn't make sense, because we're living in an era of accountability. Mm-hmm. Each person needs to be accountable for their actions, whether they happened in 1964 or not. Fire tenders were bought in this country. Yes, they affected you and I as a taxpayer. Privatization, on the other hand, affected the whole country to this date. We are still affected by it. I'm not saying the other evil is better, but I'm looking at each and every single individual. You have been calling people thieves, they are looters, and they do this, and I'll be a better person and I can do a better job. But if we look at your track record, Mr. Hichilema, what have you done for this country to get us to where we are today? That is what we are asking. How did you amass your wealth? It's a very simple question. Nobody's trying to kill you. On your Facebook page, perhaps do us a favor and maybe write a statement as to how much you are worth before privatization and all of that, as opposed to, you know, addressing everything else except the real question. And that is the real question. I think from there we can move on. Sun International, tell us how this happened. Excuse yourself from Ramcos. Do this. And I think that's all. And that's all. Nobody's trying to witch hands. Nobody's trying to make
see how many people lost their jobs during that time. Zamte was so dilapidated. It's depressing. And to see how much they have struggled to just get their terminal benefits and everything. That's the impact of privatization. Okay? And you take it all the way back to the 90s. I know the people that were there felt the impact of privatization and whatnot. But the question that we're asking today is a question of accountability, that everybody else that was involved during that time, how and what role did you play?
Yeah.
Did you do things in the interest of you and your own family? Or did you put the interest of the nation first?
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
And that's for everyone involved.
And, you know, there's this tendency of trying to play victim. And I'll call it as it is. When Mr. Hichilema is probed or asked, usually you will find that the UPND go into defense mode. You know, you find yourself being attacked on social media, insulted, being talked about, just because questions have been asked towards him. I think himself as a leader, that's something that he needs to condemn. One, condemn with the utmost distaste and just say, look, if things come to me and things I'm asked about certain things, don't go into defense mode and start insulting people and posting people and character assassinating people. It's in bad taste. It makes the party look a certain way. It's a very simple thing. Once, if the UPND leader has asked something, let him just respond. Don't start saying, you're attacking him. You are trying to what? Question, gana wa kuipisha. Iwe, ushechili so. You're for any yellow, nanguni black. Wala ask a question. We move on. Nobody is trying to find something wrong with him. We just want the answers.
Yeah.
Either so we can have more faith in him and continue to love him, or we decide, okay, this is what you did. Maybe you're not the person for me. It's a very simple issue. And everybody has got that right.
What a time to come out clean.
Exactly.
What a time to come out clean.
And I think, you know, Mutale, with what you're saying, with Zambia, I think we let our politicians get away with a lot of things.
And we should. Yes.
In opposition or in the ruling party.
Thank you.